seeing these small hometown companies, these great little ideas that start in Monroe and West Monroe and Northeast Louisiana, can propel growth for this entire region. CenturyLink is a prime example. I'm a big advocate of CenturyLink. Those are some great people with some great ideas. We are fortunate to have people like Glenn Post, John Jones, and the rest of their leadership team, because they want to see Monroe and Northeast Louisiana prosper. They could have packed their bags up and moved to another city a long time ago, but they decided to stay here and make this place their home. And I want to do everything as the next city councilman to support their efforts, to communicate with them. I've been there, I've toured their buildings, I've met with their leadership team, I've got a great working relationship with them. I sit on a volunteer group called the Wachita Business Alliance with several of the members, both of CenturyLink, Chase, and other large corporations, but not only the large corporations, the small corporations too. We have a diverse group of people that want to see Northeast Louisiana prosper. And it's more than just Monroe. It's about Monroe, West Monroe, Sterlington, Richwood, and all the communities in between. I think having someone, an advocate, that's at the table with the business leaders, bringing these ideas to the forefront, making change at that level, and then working throughout the community to implement those changes is going to be critical going forward. Now, as your next city councilman, I have a kind of a big vision, and that's what I want to bring to the table, a bigger vision. We can't do the things the way we've always done them. We've got to change. Technology's changing, people are changing, people want different things. So I will be a candidate that wants to work, of course, in the crime arena. We do have challenges in District 1 in the crime arena. When I was president of the Garden District Neighborhood Alliance, I started our first Neighborhood Watch program, where we got you and I in our cars and trucks, and we drove around and we patrolled the neighborhoods. We reported suspicious things to police officers. We were vigilant. We worked as a team. We've got to do that citywide. There's got to be a partnership between the public and the government sectors to work together to solve these problems. But government also has their role too. When you look at opportunities to reduce crime, I think things like lighting districts are important. We need to work on bright, white light in neighborhoods where you can see. Statistically, it deters crime, and it's a project I've committed to the citizens of District 1 to work on when I'm elected. Obviously, business development's a big deal, and I think that in District 1, we don't have a tremendous number of businesses that are actually in the district. But there are several retail businesses, and I'm committed to working with them on ideas, and whether it's me just spending time with them to share ideas or thoughts or figure out ways that the Monroe City Council can work better for them, I'm 100% open to that. I've shared on Facebook and other social networks, and I'll share with you today my cell phone number. Any of you that own businesses, and you don't have to be in District 1, you can be anywhere. Call me. Let me see what I can do to help you. Whether it's just an idea or just a shoulder to cry on because your minimum wage rates got pushed up too high and you can't afford to pay your people and you got to fire them now. Let me tell you, I'm going to work with you to work on solutions. Work on solutions to improve the district and improve our city. This is more than just a city election. This is a regional election. This impacts us in a big way and people outside of the region in a big way. Let me tell you a little bit about my volunteer background.